Artistic text is useful for adding single words or short lines of text, such as headlines, to a document. You can then apply a wide range of effects to the artistic text, such as drop shadows or a contour. You can add artistic text along an open or closed path, or assign hyperlinks to the artistic text object. To add artistic text, using the text tool, click anywhere on the drawing page and type. You can convert artistic text to paragraph text by selecting the artistic text using the pick tool and then clicking text. Convert to paragraph text. The text tool property bar gives you access to the font list box, which includes all the filters and collections from Corel Font Manager. You can change the style, the font alignment, turn interactive OpenType on or off. And if the font used is a variable font, access the variable font properties. The edit command allows you to modify the text using a text editor. Under options, you can access additional features such as a spell checker, grammatic checker, and a thesaurus. Text options takes you to CorelDRAW's text options, where you can set up default settings for how you would like text to be handled. Many of the settings here can also be found under the text menu. Click on Import to import text from external documents, such as Word documents, text, RTF, and Microsoft Excel files. Returning to the text property bar, clicking on the text button will open up the appropriate panel in the properties docker. Depending on the keyboards installed on your computer, the icons for changing text direction will be active. So, if you have Japanese, Chinese, Hebrew, or Arabic keyboards installed, you'll be able to switch typing direction from left to right, to right to left, and from horizontal to vertical. See also the text direction and text orientation buttons in the paragraph text panel of the properties docker. Note that just having specific language fonts available on your system is not enough. This feature will only work when the appropriate keyboards are installed on your computer. CorelDRAW's OpenType engine is highly important for designers because it enhances their typographic control and creativity. CorelDRAW supports OpenType fonts, so you can take advantage of their advanced typographic features, which allow you to choose an alternate appearance for an individual character, also referred to as a glyph, or a sequence of characters. You can let CorelDRAW prompt you which OpenType features you can apply by enabling the interactive OpenType option. When you select text, an indicator arrow appears below the text if an OpenType feature is available. You can click the indicator to access a list of the most popular available OpenType features. Here is a selection of fonts that offer interesting alternative style sets. Ligatures automatically connect certain letter pairs, like FI or FL, to improve readability and aesthetics. Some fonts include swashes, decorative letter forms for creating more visually engaging typography. Contextual alternates automatically adjust letters depending on their placement in a word, useful for scripts or handwriting fonts. Small caps and number variants are perfect for designing with text-heavy content, such as magazines or brochures. CorelDRAW's OpenType engine enables the use of multilingual typography, which is particularly useful for global designers. The engine supports multiple scripts, including Latin, Cyrillic, Greek, Arabic, Hebrew, and also diacritic marks, which are essential for designing in languages with accents and special characters. By integrating OpenType features directly within the CorelDRAW interface, designers can streamline their workflow without needing to jump between external software to make typographic adjustments. This is particularly useful when working on complex projects that require consistent typography across various design elements. The OpenType features available will depend on what the font manufacturer has built into their font. You can also access OpenType commands and options in the character area of the properties docker. Artistic text is called just that for a reason. We can reshape text objects and apply a variety of effects. Let's start by reshaping our artistic text with the envelope docker. Select the text object. Open the envelope docker. Choose a preset shape. Or click the Create Envelope from button and point to a custom shape to use as a template. Use the Shape tool to drag the nodes and adjust the shape. Artistic text can be cut with the Knife tool to create interesting, quirky effects. Select the text object, then the Knife tool. Cut through the text and reposition or rotate it. After cutting, the text object has been converted to curves and can be reshaped using the Shape tool. Using the various distortion tools in the Shape tool flyout menu, you can reshape artistic text by applying twirls, smears, and other organic effects. Select the text object and then convert to curves from the object menu. From the Shape tool flyout menu, select one of the distortion tools, for example, twirl. Let's try the smear tool. Apply uniform, patterned, and gradient transparencies to artistic text to blend your text with your artwork and create interesting effects. Select the Transparency tool from the toolbox. From the Property bar, select one of the transparency modes. Let's try out Uniform, Gradient, and Pattern transparencies. Select Vector Pattern Transparency and choose a pattern from the library. Adjust the pattern width. Adjust the amount of transparency. Creating contours. You can contour an object or artistic text to create a series of concentric lines that progress to the inside or outside of the object. CorelDRAW also lets you set the number of the contour lines and the distance between them. In addition to creating interesting 3D effects as well as shading in complex illustrations, you can use contours to create cuttable outlines for output to devices, such as plotters, engraving machines, and vinyl cutters. Open the Contours docker. Select the text object. Set the number of contour steps. Choose center, inside or outside contours. Set the width or offset. Choose from mitered, rounded, or chamfered corners. Select a contour fill color. Click Apply. To edit each contour, right-click and break the contour group apart from the text. Click the contour group again, and then ungroup all objects on the property bar. Each contour can now be treated as a separate object. The Block Shadow tool in CorelDRAW lets you add solid shadows to objects and text. Unlike drop shadows and extrusions, block shadows consist of simple lines, which makes them ideal for screen printing and sign making. You can adjust the depth and direction of a block shadow, and you can change its color. A block shadow may contain holes, but you can remove them to create a solid curve object. If the document is to be exported or printed, use Simplify to remove overlapping areas between the object and its block shadow. After simplifying, right-click and break the block shadow apart. When an object with a block shadow is brought into focus mode, the object and the block shadow are brought into focus together. Once in focus mode, you can select and edit the object and the block shadow separately. CorelDRAW includes a wide range of effects that you can apply to vector and text objects, object groups, or image areas. Effects are applied non-destructively, so you can add, edit, remove, show, or hide them, and revert to the original object or image at any point. Select the object, or in this case artistic text, that you'd like to apply an effect to. On the Properties Docker, click on the FX tab. Choose an effect from the list and apply. Multiple effects can be applied. Even after an effect has been applied, the text can be edited further. The effect is saved with the file and can be adjusted the next time the file is opened. Converting objects, including artistic text objects, in hyperlinks in CorelDRAW is easy. You can link to a web address, FTP server, email address, bookmark, or file. When the object is clicked, it opens to the assigned location in appropriate application. After you create hyperlinks, you can display and verify them. You can also delete links. When working with text, you can assign a hyperlink to both artistic and paragraph text. Using the Pick tool, click the object or text object to which you want to apply a hyperlink. To assign a hyperlink to objects in text, open the Sources Docker. Click the New Link button. From the Link Type list box, choose one of the following link types. Publishing to PDF.